Hello and welcome to Old Ways Gardening and Prepping. My name is Teresa. I'd like to welcome you to the back part of my property, also kind of referred to as the jungle, which is fixing to get fixed before long. And today I want to introduce you to one of several extremely loved medicinal plants by me. And this is goldenrod. We had a little bit of rain come through, and it is finally deciding to bloom. Now, what you want to do, and let me show you how I harvest it. This is how I harvest it. And also, I need to say, I am not a medical licensed doctor, nor am I a practicing physician. I'm an herbalist who makes medicine for my family and for those who want to heal themselves and for those who want to make their own decisions not to be medicated to death. With that being said, now let's have some fun. And the way I do it is you want, of course, you're going to have to go through the leaves. Some of the leaves look really bad this year because we've been in a drought. Let me aim the camera down, and hopefully you don't hear too much of the background noise. But you want to pick your goldenrod, harvest your goldenrod, just as it's getting ready to flower. Not, you can use it later on in full flower, but I tried to catch it just as it's getting ready to flower. And as you can see, let's get a close-up. You can see that the flower buds are there, but they're not fully open. And you definitely want to make sure you get stem and the leaves as well. Now, a lot of people swear that they're allergic to goldenrod pollen. Oh, they're allergic to it. No, they're not. Goldenrod and ragweed bloom at the same time. The reason why goldenrod is the medicine to take for the ragweed allergies. Ragweed pollen is transported through the air. Goldenrod pollen is too heavy to be wind transported. It is a thick, kind of like sap pollen. It takes insects and pollinators to move the pollen because it's too sticky to be and too heavy to be wind pollinated. So there you go, myth busted about people being allergic to goldenrod. It's ragweed that you're allergic to because it's blooming as well, and I've been trying to eradicate that one out of my yard. It's a hard one and you have to pull it up by the root. But what we're going to do is fight the horrid, and as you see here, I don't know if you can see, bees absolutely love goldenrod. See, there's a big honeybee, there's a honeybee, there's another honeybee. So you have to be careful how you harvest, because this is almost the last big flowering food that the bees can harvest to make their honey. So harvest responsibly, everybody. Don't just clear out all of the goldenrod. Like I said, the bees need it. They're just covered with bees and the native bees and the little bitty wasps. So harvest responsibly and make sure that you leave some for them. Today I'll be teaching you how to make a goldenrod tincture. I'll have several other videos that I'll be making. One is to make a goldenrod tea. Now I'm going to tell you right now, goldenrod lies to you. It smells wonderful as a tea. You're going to need honey or strong constitution because it's astringent. Now, another wonderful, I'm avoiding that pepperberry bun. Now, let's talk a little more about the wonderful healing benefits of goldenrod. As I fight my camera, apparently, I can't focus it like I want to. Goldenrod is an amazing healer tonic for your bladder and your kidneys. It strengthens and tones them. Also, it is one of the best tonics for UTI infections. And it helps with kidney stones and so many other things. And what it does is the goldenrod strengthens your bladder and also your urinary tract muscles. It helps tone them. And also, like I said, it gets rid of UTI infections, bladder infections, you name it. It's also anti-inflammatory, it's antibacterial, it's antiviral. And I'll go into more discussion as I'm making the tincture, and plus I'll have even more information in the description box below. I'm trying to avoid the pepperberry vine to harvest goldenrod, because I do not want it on my goldenrod at all. And today I'll be harvesting enough goldenrod to get one batch of tincture done. I was just so happy for the rain that we got. We've been desperately needing rain. I'm gonna go over here and grab some. Okay, I have enough harvested. I have a good handful, and that should be plenty enough to get a good tincture started. And like I said, the poor little bees are coming up to me. Let's see if you can see it. The bees are coming up to pollinate them as I'm picking them. Which makes me feel bad, but I have left plenty. Alright, and I will see you up at the canopy here in just a few. Okay, I have made it safely back up to the canopy. I had bees following me, and I was buzzed by two different hummingbirds trying to get my goldenrod. So be prepared. Also, I have let it sit for a little while. I have cleaned off all the damaged leaves that I can see. Now one morning, and they're not poisonous, so don't worry, there'll be a lot of little spiders. Spiders also love goldenrod. Don't let that deter you from harvesting it. Just let them sit and they will crawl off on their own. There's a lot of insects that we in the herbal world have to deal with. And I just let them go. There's no need to kill them because they're outside. Just let them crawl off. Now, I am dealing with, apparently there's a child somewhere next door over having a hissy fit that deserves an Oscar. So, if it gets too loud again, I'll have to pause it, and I apologize ahead of time. It's out of my control, but if it was in my control, that wouldn't be happening. Okay, now, let's get back to talking about making a goldenrod tincture. This is one amazing healing plant. Not only, like I said, it tones and strengthens your urinary tract, your bladder, your kidneys, all of that. And this is one herb that if you have prolonged urinary tract problems, this is one that you can take on a daily basis that will not harm you. This you can take on a regular period for a long time to cure up, like I said, urinary tract infections. If you have a weak bladder, this will help with it. If you have problems with your kidneys, this will help with it. This is one amazing medicinal. Also, you can either infuse it in oil, which I will show you how to do in a later video. It is amazing for burns. It will heal burns and wounds as well. Also, it is antibacterial, antimicrobial, antiviral. The list goes on and on. I'll have even more information in the description box below. It's good for your lungs. It's good for sinus problems. It's just a wonder drug. Well, not a wonder drug. Let me take that back. It's a wonderful medicinal healer. Sometimes we get stuck using words that's been programmed into us, and it takes most of your life to get deprogrammed, and that's one thing I'm still working on, because you hear so much, and it just gets into your mind. But let me not get on my soapbox, because that could take a long while to get off of. But what you're going to want to do is, like I said, you want the flower buds, you want leaves, and you want stems, all of the top of the goldenrod. Now, like I said, harvest responsibly, leave some for the bees and the pollinators, because this is the last big flowering push before winter comes. But you're just gonna, I see a dead leaf. And as you can see, I've got pollinators coming after me, a nasty old fly. And as you're cutting up, if you'll smell it, you can smell the astringency in them. Now, like I said, I'm going to be making many other videos as well. You're going to want to definitely make tincture. You're going to definitely want to dry some. And I'll be showing you a tea mix that you can mix with it. This is one that you definitely want to have plenty of stored back for winter, until it blooms again next year. You're going to have to judge and put back enough to make sure you have plenty. Because, like I said, it also cures wounds as well. And you want to get it cut up so that the alcohol can circulate all in it. And, like I said, 100 proof vodka, because it is a juicy plant. And the vodka has 50% alcohol, 50% water. So it will balance, pull out all the medicinals of the goldenrod. And what you do is just put it down in your jar, And I'm using a half a gallon jar as usual. You don't have to make as much, but this is one tincture that you definitely want to have in your home. Now, if you are allergic to bees, just make sure the bees aren't going to bother you unless you bother them. But just make sure that you have your EpiPen with you if you go harvesting goldenrod. Don't be paranoid. Don't let paranoia bother you. Don't ever let paranoia stop you from doing anything. But be wise when you do go gathering. Make sure if you're EpiPen allergic to anything, always make sure you have that with you. And like I said, you don't want to waste anything. Make sure you get it all up. Okay. And if I was to mush that down, it'd be a good packed half jar. Now, yes, my alcohol bottle looks more full. I had some extra 100 proof vodka that I poured on up in it. Okay, now I'm going to fill it on up. I want to make sure that I get all the air bubbles out. Make sure that it's swirled around in there real good. You do not want any air bubbles in your jar with your goldenrod. And then I'm going to open it back up. And I'm going to top it off. And I just barely had enough. Good thing I put the extra vodka in the bottle. Okay, make sure there's no goldenrod on your rim. And take a Sharpie marker. Right. Golden. Rod tincture, and this is September, can't remember the date, but I'll fix that here in a minute, and 21. And what you're going to do is every day, every other day, agitate it. I don't know if you can see how beautiful that is. It's beautiful. Now, every day, every other day, make sure that you agitate it. Turn it about every week. Check, make sure your alcohol level doesn't drop below the rim. If it does, add more alcohol to it. That'll be fine. And in eight weeks, your tincture will be ready. Now, don't worry if you have to go over 8 weeks. It's not going to hurt the tincture. The tincture's done at 8 weeks, so you don't have to worry about that. It can go over 8 weeks, but you want to make sure that you get this soaked for at least 8 weeks. You want to put it in a dark, cool place, and then at 8 weeks, a little after 8 weeks, you can strain it, or you can leave it just like it is. It will be fine, I promise you. Simple, easy, anybody can make tincture. You just have to believe in yourself, and please make sure you know exactly what plants you are harvesting. Goldenrod is fairly easy to know. There's no poisonous lookalikes that I know of, unless somebody's playing Frankenstein in a lab somewhere. But now, I do not know what species of goldenrod I have, but there are so many different kinds of goldenrod around America and the world. Just know what you're harvesting and make sure. And like I said, 100 proof vodka, because since my goldenrod has took forever to bloom, it waited for rain, which we finally got rain. There's a good chance it soaked up a whole lot of rain, so make sure you use at least 100 proof vodka. Don't go over 100 proof, because then it's not medicinal. It can do more harm than good, and that's why I never use Everclear. I don't use jet fuel. Simple, easy, anybody can make their own medicine to heal yourselves. Now, I have more healing information in the description box below, so please take time to read that. Also, please click the like and subscribe button so you can come along on more adventures of herbology, canning, prepping, cooking, and common sense. Everyone, please click the bell notification so you'll be notified when I upload another video. Go outside, either dig in the dirt, harvest you some goldenrod. And like I said, I'm going to be doing several more videos. I've got a lot of goldenrod that I need to harvest and put away in different ways. And I'm going to bring you along on each one. Please take care. Stay safe out there. Keep on prepping. Please put food back, because you're going to need to. Stay safe, stay smart, and above all else, no matter what, stay positive. Because if you worry about stuff, it only makes you sick inside, and it hurts your organs. And you don't want to be losing no gallbladders right now. Take care. And I look forward to seeing you in my next video. And may you each be blessed. I'll see you soon.